Hey guys, today it's all about pets and how you're gonna do it. All you need is basically a DHW and a polyphonic synthesizer and some time, FX and knowledge. And we're gonna start right off. The first thing we're gonna do is adding the synth. In this case, it's the polysynth from Bitbig. And let's try to press a note. Sounds not so nice, so we're adding voices, spreading the voices apart or detune it, turning the cutoff down, choosing a different filter, choosing a different envelope for the filter, long release, long attack, the amp envelope, long attack, long release. And of course, we are choosing the filter envelope depth. That's okay for now. So we're gonna try this knob because I like it. Filter Oscillator FM. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is adding subtle modulations to different parameters in the synth. And this is, I'm adding a random modulator and I'm choosing triggering free. So the modulator is running freely without triggering on each note press. So I'm choosing a slow LFO and smoothing is 100%. And I'm going to modulate the pitch. Just a touch. The special thing about this modulator is that this modulator is polyphonic. So it's basically a modulation of the pitch for each played voice. Different modulation. So we're gonna have a very nice floating kind of pad. It sounds very alive and that's exactly what we want. And of course, we are duplicating this and trying to modulate different parameters like the unison and maybe the cutoff frequency a bit and maybe the filter oscillator FM. And yeah, that's okay for now. Let's try again. That's maybe a bit too much. Okay. Remember, this is basically something you can't do with automation in other DHWs. It's a random modulation. So it's differently each time you play it. And this is very nice because it's it sounds very much alive. The next thing we're gonna do is adding FX. And I'm adding a reverb. A long reverb. And of course, on the wet signal, I'm applying one EQ. Low pass, high pass. So we're gonna remove the high end and the bottom. That's okay, but we're only pressing here one key, and of course chords sound always a bit nicer, and we're gonna do this by adding one multi-note device, which kind of gives us firstly the root note, then one note three semitones above the root note, and 1/7 semitones above the root note. And I'm choosing something for the bass, which is 1 octave below the root note. Or maybe we choose 24 semitones below. 12 is enough. So it sounds very nice to the ear. Something we also can do is modulating the pan. And we are gonna do this by also a random modulator, because we can do this with the LFO just for a test. So it's basically moving in rhythms from left to right, which is okay. But I think if you use a random modulator, it sounds more like a real thing. And remember, the modulators are also polyphonic, so it's basically a pan modulation for each voice differently. So we have different voices layered on each other, and every voice has its own panning applied to it randomly. So it's every time you play it, it's different. And this is very nice, of course. So we have one basic pad created, and we choose a multi-note to create a chord out of it. And the next thing we're gonna do is to constrain the chord to a specific scale. And I'm using the diatonic transposer again, choosing C minor. And now every note I'm pressing on the keyboard is a correct chord in C minor. So let's try it. I'm pressing first C. You can see it here down below on the keyboard, what I'm pressing. This is okay, and what this pad is missing, maybe, or maybe not, it depends on your taste, is a little bit of sparkle on top, or like a texture on top, so to make it more interesting. And we're gonna collapse this, hit Control and A to select all devices, and hit Control and G for grouping these three devices together. And now we have an instrument layer, inside this instrument layer is one layer with the devices we just created. And it works just exactly like before. But we're gonna add another layer on top of this, and I'm choosing again a polysynth, and this time we're gonna try to make some very small sounds, just soloing this. Okay, and I'm adding again one delay, keep it interesting. And I'm modulating with the random modulator the octave. So every time I press a key, the octave changes and I have a different frequency range. Now I'm using the modulator to modulate different envelope times. And I want to change the sound. I'm trying to change the sound more with the sync knob. Okay. Let's add one reverb. That's okay. Now we are adding the echo, note echo, like yesterday in the last tutorial, and I'm choosing maybe 5 repetitions, and I'm wanting the velocity to go down a bit, and of course lower delay times. And of course, I'm trying to remove the low end. So we're gonna just have top end sounds. And maybe add one random modulator to modulate the pan again. And blend it together with our pad sound. Let's take this diatonic transposer in here, so we have always the right key, choosing C minor like in the layer above, and here it's the same. So I'm renaming this add texture, and maybe we can add some kind of lead sound. I'm choosing again a pulley synth and soloing this. Let's add reverb. One EQ to actually EQ the wet signal of the reverb. That's okay. And now we're gonna add again one diatonic transposer, C minor, and this is maybe interesting. We're gonna add again one woody note. Just copying this here. So we have a pad. But we don't want to play a chord, we want to play a small progression. And I'm using a VST plugin called Cthulhu, extremely well to be pronounced by Germans. I'm removing this chord thing, removing all steps, just taking this, just take the lung. Lowering the speed, choosing this, maybe this, this, and maybe this. Let's hear it when I press a note. So what's happening here? In this layer, I'm having a multi-note which outputs multiple notes from one key note. In this case, it's C. This device constrains every note of this device to C minor, so we have correct chords. And this device, Cthulhu, is selecting one note from the chord at each time. So in this point here, I'm selecting the lowest note. Here, selecting the fifth note, the fourth note, the second, and so on. So we can actually play a melody with the chord progression or with the chord input by this multi-note device. And this is very interesting because you can come up with nice melodies only by playing chords. Let me re-trigger on each key press. So let's play everything together. So if I'm collapsing this layer, you can see we just started with the pad, added a texture on top, and then a lead sound, all with the same techniques, just transforming and adding notes or changing the sounds via random modulators. And all you have to do basically is to come up with a melody or a note sequence. So all I'm doing basically is just pressing one note here, the C, and then a G. And it just sounds like a track you can you can release, right? No, maybe not, but you get the idea. And I just wanted you to tell how you can create pads and maybe atmospheric sounds inside Bitwig or in other DHWs. I don't know how modular your DHW is, but you can see just by layering, transforming and applying modulators, it's very easy and nice and fun way to do. So I hope you learned something today in this tutorial. If you do, then please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. There's more coming soon. Bye.